campus of Stone Hill College. Thank you so much for making us a part of your Friday afternoon alongside Pam Arpe. I'm Andrew Kappas. Pam, you coached here at Stone Hill for 8 seasons, and in this first matchup, we have two teams that you're very familiar with out of the PSAC. It's a rematch of the PSAC championship game from a couple of weeks ago, and I think defense is going to be the key, at least on paper.
Totally. When I looked at the stats for both goalies, this is going to be pretty exciting. I think if someone was looking for a high-scoring game, it might not be the place that they will be this afternoon. I think we're going to see tremendous defense.
We very well may get a high-scoring game in our second semifinal game between LIU Post and St. Anselm, but this one, you talked about it, Pam, it's very rare you see a goalkeeping matchup like this. You have the top two goalkeepers statistically in Division II. Goals allowed averages of .57 for Samantha Rumler for Millersville. That's second in D2, and her counterpart, Allie Mooney, just a sophomore, leading all Division II keepers with a .42 goals against average.
You don't see that very often in field hockey. Field hockey tends to be low-scoring games, but nothing like these two have demonstrated for the season. And the number of shutouts between the two goalies is amazing. And I have to think the two defenses are going to be equally as strong.
It's going to be a very entertaining one as Millersville huddles up one final time. Shippensburg leaving their sideline. A good crowd here at W.B. Mason Stadium. This is such a fantastic facility here on the campus of Stone Hill in suburban Boston in Easton, Massachusetts. Last year, it was held on the campus of Bloomsburg and Bloomsburg, PA, alternating between the NE10 and the PSAC. This year, the NE10's turn to host it. And perfect weather here today, Pam. We look at the skies above us. You're local here. Obviously, we mentioned you coached here at Stonehill. Not only field hockey, but you also coach tennis as well. We're going to be right about 60 when we get underway. Not a cloud in the sky. Certainly doesn't feel like it's November 18th.
It doesn't. We're pretty lucky, and it is a fabulous day for field hockey. These girls, this is perfect playing weather. The sun is not too hot, but it just gives them enough warmth so you can see they're all out there with their sleeveless tops on and They're fine. The fans might get a little cool later on, but for the players, this is a picture-perfect day.
Shippensburg in white getting us underway. Millersville, the Marauders, looking like the Pittsburgh Pirates out there in the black and yellow. Let's see how these two teams start, Pam. We talked about how we had a similar situation in last year's semifinals where we were expecting a really defensive affair in the PSAC game, which was the second semifinal last year, ended up getting a high-scoring bout in which East Stroudsburg prevailed. So you never know. It was 6-2 last year over Westchester for East Stroudsburg. But speaking of the Warriors, they are the defending national champion, but we'll get a new one. Fourth consecutive year, we'll have a brand-new national champion. East Stroudsburg was knocked off by Shippensburg in the first round last Friday.
And I love that. I love to have four new teams each year. It sends a message to all the teams out there that maybe it could be them. So I think it's exciting every year when we see new players out here, new teams.
Margaret Thorwart getting us restarted from the near sideline, just underway here at W.B. Mason Stadium. Now let's talk about how these two teams got here, Pam. Millersville kind of stalled in middle of the season. They had a run of three straight losses, but boy, they have been red hot lately and rattled off three wins to get through the PSAC tournament as champions.
They did, and I think, you know, anyone in the athletic world would probably be saying they are peaking at the right time. They're playing their best field hockey right now. So good for them, and I'm sure they're looking forward to having a great day today as well.
Yeah, when their season stalled, they were maybe wondering if they were going to be able to participate in the tournament, maybe needing a strong PSAC tournament run, but I don't know if they were thinking first round bye, which is what they got.
Right. But that just shows, you know, they've got 8 seniors, and I have to think that senior leadership played a part in pulling them together and getting them to where they are today.
On the far side, it's been mostly Millersville with the ball here early on, but they haven't been able to get inside the circle just yet, which is no surprising.
Now, not a surprise.
The goalkeepers, they get a lot of the attention, but really the back defenders have done such a tremendous job too. Maybe some of the unsung heroes, if you will.
I think so. No, defenders rarely get any attention, but I think the goalies would be the first to admit that it's not just themselves, that that line in front of them is key to the success of each goalie.
Now, while we did mention we are going to get a new national champion for the fourth straight year, with East Stroudsburg getting beat in the first round by Shippensburg. These are two teams with winning pedigrees that have won recently. Millersville last won in 2014, Shippensburg the year before that. So there are quite a few players on this field right now that do have national championship rings, and that experience is very valuable.
Very valuable. I think that'll play a part today, you know, as we go down the stretch, and if it stays 0-0 or a very close game, I think we will see teams really pull together because they've been here before. They know what the outcome needs to be for their teams.
Well, Allie Mooney has had to at least be on alert on this end. Her jersey has been clean. No shots just yet from Millersville. Hard to believe she is just a sophomore.
I know it.
A 0.42 goals against average, leading Division II this season. And now Shippensburg will have a chance to clear from the far side. They have yet to have a possession in Millersville territory just yet, but granted, we're only 4.5 minutes into the match so far.
Right, but it's all been down here, but no corners been called, so I think it shows right here, Shippensburg, they can shut down the attack coming at them.
But Millersville will have another chance to restart. They haven't even really gotten the ball inside the circle just yet.
All right, that was a good, successful throw by the Marauders.
Millersville trying to take advantage of this early spell of possession, but Shippensburg's defense has held up well, and this is really kind of where the ball's been living, either on this side or on the far side of it. And you're not going to be too troubled if you're Allie Mooney or her defenders.
No, she's probably feeling, okay, ladies, let's get the ball to the other end.
At least get a mental break in with the ball on the other end as they try to clear.
Right.
But a good start for Millersville nonetheless, even though really nothing has come of it just yet, as we have a whistle and a foul. That one is going to go against Ariana Grays of Millersville. Came up a little aggressive. Ended up running through Morgan Gantz. But again, it's out and back for Millersville.
Back for the Marauders, putting just that constant pressure, which any coach is happy to see early in the game. I'm sure Coach Behrens is thinking, okay, ladies, let's keep it down at this end.
Now, Millersville, quite the run. We spoke about it just a few moments ago. And Shippensburg, they had to beat the defending champs. There's a good opportunity here right on top of the circle for Millersville.
Trying to insert it and see if they can just get a corner. Anytime a team is down this close to that penalty corner, they're going to work hard to create some kind of havoc in the circle so they can get their penalty corner.
That's another thing that I've been impressed with, Pam, again, in the opening 5.5 minutes at least, is a lot of times you see teams kind of use that end line as a bit of a crutch and maybe concede the penalty corner. Shippensburg hasn't really done that. They've kept a buffer zone away from that end line.
They have, and good team defense here. You can see them really working as a unit. It's not just a one-on-one. There were a lot of defenders around the ball.
So now Millersville trying to change sides of the field after an attempted clearance by Shippensburg. Again, Shippensburg in white.
Good double team right there. Shippensburg is rewarded with the ball.
Now, this is the first time they've had it at midfield since they got us underway. It'll be short-lived, but progress at least.
Progress. I'm sure they're happy to get it inside their 50.
Now the Raiders 18-3 overall, 9-1 in the PSAC. And they had to defeat the defending national champ East Stroudsburg last Friday, 2-1. Caitlin Grizon, the winning goal. East Stroudsburg scored in the first half to go up 1-0 at recess, but then 2 second-half goals by Shippensburg eliminated the Warriors and ensured a new national champion this year.
East Stroudsburg, again, they're going to try to attack. They've got their players moving. All right, she is going forward. Sometimes we'll see it's, you know, the best way to go forward is to go back first, transfer that ball, but they're trying to get that ball upfield.
Yeah, it's very similar to soccer where you sometimes do have to drop the ball back.
Absolutely.
To kind of reestablish the attack. And just because there's so much space to cover for a defense, so if you can flip sides of the field, you might be able to find some holes a little easier.
Absolutely. And in recent years, that has been just key for most teams. As we see the their formation. They've always got someone back so that they can transfer that ball if they don't see anything going forward.
And that's really where ball handling skills come in as a defender as well. You don't just have to worry anymore in the last handful of years about clearing it. You got to be able to handle the stick as well, because you're going to be called upon.
You do, and you've got to be very steady back there. If someone transfers the ball and you miss it, you've exposed their goalie. So, you know, the defensive players are just so key.
And this is the third time these two teams have met, as Millersville, an opportunity inside the circle. Mooney called upon
great
for the
shot.
First time, able to make one save. Not out of danger yet. The Marauders, a pass in front of the goal, deflected out.
And
a really good run for the Marauders, as we'll have our first penalty corner of the afternoon. But a very close play there. I think Mooney lost sight of the ball, picked it up at the last moment. She was going to ground, and she was able to get her right shoulder on it and get our first save of the afternoon.
And the Marauders were all over that rebound. So you can tell they're pretty intent on getting a scoring opportunity right here.
So the penalty corner taken, just on the edge of the circle now, takes a deflection back out.
And they will get the ball right on the 20-yard line, and they're going to try to 25-yard line and bring it in again.
Now Shippensburg trying to bend but not break here, as Millersville, a very good run to start the match. Now almost 10 minutes in, and Marauders have really dominated possession and our first chance of the afternoon, but a chance now for Shippensburg to clear it.
Hold on to the ball a little bit too long there.
A good takeaway for Millersville. You have to like the way the Marauders have started this match.
And look at that double team everywhere. They're really, they want that ball. They're feeling pretty hungry right now with two Marauders on the ball on every single ball.
And that is another thing, Pam. You talk about how fresh each team is. It's been a week since Shippensburg played. It's been even longer for Millersville, so you almost wonder if that's an advantage, at least early on, for Shippensburg. Just a little bit more fresh in terms of having actual game action within the last 7 days. But Millersville, they haven't played competitive field hockey since that PSAC championship game against Shippensburg.
Absolutely, and it makes you wonder if they're just so fresh and they're so ready and they've got those nice fresh legs that they're ready to go. They're perhaps missed having games. Nice passing here by the Marauders.
And close quarters, able to get down an additional 15 yards. Still alive for the Marauders as they'll try to swing it towards the circle from the near side. 10 minutes into our first half of our first semifinal.
Kind of a desperation play right there by Shippensburg, just to send it over the sideline, just to kind of regroup. That gives the defense a little time to regroup.
Their only regular season meeting was back on October the 12th, as we'll have another penalty corner. Second of the afternoon, the second just the last couple of minutes for Millersville.
And you'll see all of the Marauders are talking right there at the top of the circle. Right now they're deciding which set play they're going to run. Penalty corners are practiced day in and day out. They are set plays, so they have a number of them, so let's see what they give us this time.
We swung in from the near side. Three Marauders bracing towards the far post.
Defense was right there, though.
Very good interception inside the circle. I think that was Rachel Moore who got in the way there.
And a good job bringing that ball out quickly, which is the job of the defender in the circle. Get it out of that circle, bring it to the sidelines, send it right up. Just try to get it away from the scoring area.
Especially on a penalty corner, you got so many attacking bodies in there that you really can't wait around for a short clearance. You just got to try to get it away.
Just hustle that ball out.
But it's Millersville still dominating possession. They got to like where they're at right now. Mm-hmm. Not just because they're on this side of the field, but because they've basically lived on this side of the field in the opening 12 minutes.
They have, and Shippensburg's a little bit on their heels right now. I think I have to think that if they can get one good offensive push, we'd see this open up a little bit as far as getting the ball to the other end and not just down at one end.
Allie Mooney, the nation's leading goals against average keeper, has only had to make one save, but she has been watching closely.
Another penalty corner.
A three in quick succession for Millersville. Mooney lining up her defense
interesting that they're taking their penalty corners from this side of the field. Oftentimes you see teams take them from the other side. So this is what their plan is.
Carly Castle swings it in on the near side.
Nice shot. Mooney's right out there.
Now Mooney way off the line, and it's going to go back to Shippensburg. And do you like to see that as a head coach, your keeper taking charge in those situations? Or?
You do, and I think it gets her more involved in the game as well, if she can really get out there on her angle and talk to her defenders.
A very nice run
nice
for Shippensburg as they push the ball forward.
No call.
Emily Bernard ran about 20 yards with the ball, and they are at least able to flip sides of the field. Now Millersville will have it, but the first time that really the Marauders have had to clear from their own end.
Right.
But they do it pretty successfully with a couple of good passes. Thorwart able to bring
nice
it across
pass.
Midfield. Just a beautiful day here in Easton, Massachusetts. This is semifinal number one. So these two teams trying to punch their ticket into the national championship match, which will be held on Sunday afternoon here at 1 o'clock. Both winning championships recently, Millersville looking for their second title in the last 3 years. Some common opponents, too. They beat Shippensburg in the first round back in 2014 mm-hmm. and then beat LIU Post in the championship game. LIU Post, they'll play in our second semifinal against upstart St. Anselm.
Right, we've got three teams that are probably pretty familiar with them, with each other. And then St. Anselm, this is their first trip here.
Yeah, it's a really interesting story. We'll get more into that in our second semifinal. But St. Anselm just enjoyed their first winning season last year, and here they are in the semifinals.
I know, there were a lot of firsts for that program, which as a former Northeast 10 coach, it's exciting to see a program just come alive.
Just adds to the depth, not only of the league, but Division II in general.
Right.
As Shippensburg grabbing some momentum here away from Millersville. They'll have it on the near side. They'll bring it back, and it'll be set up for Kylie Huffman, a junior from Annville, Pennsylvania. Now Huffman will restart us here on the near sideline.
Yep, nice run there to receive that ball.
Now Shippensburg able to withstand that early pressure, and here they are on the other end, 15 minutes into the first half.
I'm sure Coach Landis is feeling a little more comfortable right now that she's got her team down in the attacking end.
Whipped into the circle, a very good ball in.
Absolutely. That could have been dangerous.
Millersville able to deal with it. And that's something you worry about maybe if you're Millersville, your defense hasn't had to do much.
Mm-hmm.
Samantha Rumler really has just kind of been a spectator up until the last 60 seconds or so.
Right. Sometimes that first shot, if you've been standing for a good, 10, 15 minutes, that first shot can catch you by surprise. But they held up. But here we've got Ship, another opportunity to take it into the scoring area.
Now the Raiders with their first significant spell of possession really on any end of the field, but now they're deep in Millersville territory, but the Marauders.
Good defense, good job bringing that up.
Trying to clear here, but Shippensburg was going to try to keep the pressure on. Now, Shippensburg won the regular season meeting back on October the 12th, 1-0, but then Millersville avenging that loss in the PSAC championship game.
That was a great ball put into the circle. Good one-on-one play right there. Shippensburg is not going to let that ball come out of their scoring opportunity, so great job there, one-on-one.
But you see the field flipped and how much more green space and Marauders having to chase, but
mm-hmm.
luckily for them, the ball rolling toward the sideline and away from goal, so they were able to cover. But still Shippensburg a chance to get this one into the circle.
Nice job there with the little two-person play.
And it was very good dribbling in close quarters,
yep.
But it's going to be a chance now for Millersville to flip back the field. Allie Mooney finally getting a bit of a breather on the other end. She's out about 15 yards away from her goal.
She's out pretty far, actually. When I look at there, I think this is probably her way of just staying very involved with her team. And we know she's quick enough to get back.
Indeed. Still Shippensburg possession.
Here they are transferring back just to change the point of attack a little bit. It's a nice ball going forward.
Really nice settling there.
Foot by Shippensburg. That was unlucky, but
yeah, Bernard in close proximity. Only had one defender to beat, but again, the kick.
Okay, that was a good successful throw. Unfortunately, it went to not the person that she wanted it to go to.
Yeah, trying to get that ball forward for Mezak. Haven't heard from her much. Eliza Mezak, one of the best offensive players for Millersville this season. But again, these two teams very much focusing on the defensive end. But that's been the style of play really for the most part in the PSAC. You don't have very many teams there that, in the PSAC at least this season, that score in bunches.
Right.
NE10, some of the highest scoring teams found in the NE10, including LIU Post, a team that we'll see later on tonight. But Shippensburg running with Bernard on the near side. Bernard waiting for some help, bringing it to the end line, flipping it in. Bernard in some space. Bernard the shot. And in close proximity, Bernard, another impressive run. And that was very, very close for Shippensburg. We'll take another look at it as Bernard in close proximity using that end line to her advantage, just juggling with it, Pam. What
right.
a run for
right.
her.
That was great. And that entire play started with number 24, Mary Spizak. She is playing that center mid position, and she gave a great ball to number 17, Emily Barnard. So I have to think we're going to see that combination work a little bit more.
Yeah, Bernard had a run earlier really to get the ball down on this end, and it hasn't left since.
No, she carries that ball well. She seems to understand that's what her role is out there on the edge. It's a nice ball.
On the far side, Millersville good. Now a little bit on their heels.
Right, but good pressure by Shippensburg right there, keeping it up. There we go. She won that ball just by keeping her stick down and in that play.
Now the Marauders just trying to do what Shippensburg did to start this match, and that's survive this onslaught.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to feel Shippensburg, that was a much better chance than what Millersville had. So I think a little bit of confidence now in the sails of the Raiders.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes it just takes one or two runs down the field to really get a rhythm going, and I feel like Ship has got that. Unlucky right there, hitting an ankle. The ball's coming out.
It was a very entertaining game as well, the PSAC championship game, a penalty stroke that
yeah.
resulted in the game-winning goal for
right.
Millersville.
Right.
And they went all the way from thinking maybe they would be left out of the tournament to getting a first round bye.
It's quite a run. Quite a run for Millersville to come out of fourth place and end up as that top seed.
So
getting
it's,
by.
It's maybe a bit easy to forget that Shippensburg, you know, yes, they had to play that first round game, but they beat the defending national champs. Despite that, they're 18-3. They were 9-1 in the regular season in the PSAC. So certainly a team that very easily could have gotten that first round bye as well. Only
right.
could be one. But.
Right, but a penalty stroke decided it. Yeah, there's some good momentum, but the Marauders are definitely shutting them down right now. But Shippensburg seems to have their offensive attack, their good rhythm right now, working together.
Getting in the way there, Shippensburg, of the clearance, but a whistle. It's going to go against the Marauders, so Shippensburg a chance to keep the pressure on here as
Mary Spizak right there with the ball. She's a good focal point for this team. I think the ball goes through her a lot. She looks like she's a great distributor.
Samantha but, Rumler's had to make one save, as
that's
has
nice.
Mooney. Ball
oh.
into the circle and a couple of defenders there, but a couple of missed clearances, Pam.
Right.
Nervous moments.
Okay. So Shippensburg, first corner right here. They're going to group together, same thing, talk about what set corner they're going to run.
The first opportunity for them. Millersville has had three penalty corners. Brooke Ziders will send it in.
It's a great ball coming in.
Over the top, Shippensburg trickling it back in front of net, missing everything
it.
Over the end line. And we're going to have another penalty corner. Oh, nope, just coming back out to the near side of the circle.
That's good defense right there.
Yeah, very nice job by the Marauders. But again, in a game that very well may end up 1-0, you just like what you saw there in that 7-minute spurt from
mm-hmm.
Shippensburg.
Yep.
But now a chance for Millersville to do what they did in the opening 10 minutes, and that's keep the ball on this end. with 12:50 remaining in the first half.
Some really nice stick work here by both teams.
In some traffic, very nicely done as a collision. That was some, in tight quarters, some very fancy stick work from Erica Tarsi.
And right there, same thing.
We have our first caution of the day. It's been a very clean game so far.
It has. That was just an unfortunate push right there. So she'll be out for 2 minutes. A team will play down a player for those 2 minutes.
Green card issued on Millersville number 8, Kathleen Bishop.
Kathleen Bishop is the receiving end of that green card. So, again, 2 minutes without.
That's a great ball right there. Just opening up that whole attack.
A very nice job, too, to make the turn there by Brooke Ziders, sophomore from Selins Grove, Pennsylvania. Now Shippensburg with the advantage here on the far side, trying to swing it into the circle.
Fans, head on down to the concession stand near the end zone.
Good ball in there.
Yep, great ball in, but the defense was ready.
When you go down a player like this, is it tempting to kind of go into a shell and just try to withstand this 120-second period, or do you try not to do too much different?
You really don't try to do too much different. The 2 minutes goes by pretty quickly. I think everyone knows that you've got to be on your toes, but most teams are not going to make any major changes.
Millersville able to push the ball forward despite being a player down. Good interception on the near sideline, but taken right back by Shippensburg as Rachel Moore didn't give up on the play. Moore still going forward and wins it for the Raiders. Moore with the ball, playing it, trying to get it to Ziders, but it's intercepted. Taken out, and Millersville will have it. A good start, really, for both teams now that Shippensburg had that spell.
Yep. I think now we're looking at a pretty even game.
It's exactly what was kind of advertised. And granted, right, we're still only 25 minutes in, still a lot of field hockey left to play. But this has been, I think, what we expected. And that's the chances in front of net are not very, there haven't been many, put it bluntly. And when there have been, both keepers have done a tremendous job of making sure their jersey stays clean.
Right. As I said earlier, everyone loves to see scoring, but a lot of coaches take a pride in their defense. So I think we're seeing two really fine defensive units right here.
And both Rumler and Mooney have had to make two plays here so far today, but both have answered the bell.
And this appears to be the attack. Shippensburg likes to bring it up the side here, up the left side. They're doing a nice job. It seems like most of the attack has started right over here.
Yeah, everything kind of just flowing through Rachel Moore here lately and Emily Bernard.
And now we get it to Pizak, who's going to distribute. Look at that beautiful pass. She sees that field so well, distributing the ball.
That's really important to have somebody like Spizak there in the middle.
It is.
With great vision, you can go left, right, or right back up the box.
Right, and I think that's similar to other sports. You put that center mid needs to be the distributor and pass and see the field well.
And it seems so easy, sitting from up here to say, well, you have to see the whole field well. But in the speed of the game, when you may only have a few microseconds to make a decision on which way you go, not only is the vision there, but the decision-making has to be there as well.
It's got to be instant, and then you've got to back it up with picture-perfect passing out there. And both teams have a great passing game. It's a pleasure to see that today. Not only is the stick work very good, but they all are taking the time to look up, see what their options are, and then get a good pass off.
And in some close proximity there, Mooney called upon. Yeah. She was ready, but Millersville able to get the ball inside the circle.
Right, but the defense stayed right with her and basically just forced her to dribble right over that end line.
On the far side, Millersville trying to re-enter the circle. And the back has held up so far for Shippensburg, really for both teams.
Just good pressure by the defensive sticks here.
Very nice job. As again, that's Bernard, who I think out of anybody on the field right now, she has had the most time, or the most runs, rather, with the ball.
Yes, she hangs on to it well.
And a great flip of the field by Shippensburg as they go far side now. Very nicely done. Three touch passes, really, and just like that, Shippensburg on the other end.
Yeah. That's a great ball. That's a great ball, but the Marauders were right there.
Picked off right on the edge of the circle. That's been the theme of the day for both teams. Both have really had a hard time getting the ball in the circle. Once they've been there, they've kind of been pushed out toward the end line and away from target. So everything going as scripted, I guess
yes,
you could say.
I think so.
On the far side, Millersville just trying to clear it. But again, Samantha Rumler in fairly easy territory right now. She's watching the play develop in front of her, but still some defending to do for the Marauders. Is a big collision.
Yeah, but great move by Spizak. And again, she's going to see that open player, and they're going to penetrate that circle with the ball. All right, still coming in.
So this will come from the far side of the circle. Swung into the circle.
Great, that's a dangerous ball.
Very
right
good
there.
One. Tried to pick out Ziders.
But you had two Shippensburg players right there on her. They're not going to give up this offensive push very easily.
Rachel Moore able to keep that one alive as they get it back into Bernard, and then another whistle. See if they try to center it back up for Spizak. She's in some green space in front, but they're able to get it in the circle, but it's going to come right back out. Millersville a chance to clear here. So winding down here in the first half, under 6 minutes to go. We are scoreless between Shippensburg and Millersville.
A good ball. Great stick work right there.
An excellent job yet again by Bernard as she ended up about 10 yards from goal before she was depossessed by the Marauders. And now it's Millersville trying to counter. Three defenders back, though, for Shippensburg and eventually running it down, Morgan Gantz. Gantz playing that hybrid midfield defending role for Shippensburg.
And she does it well. There we go.
Ziders on the near side trying to make the turn upfield. And it's out off Millersville. Rachel Moore on the near side waiting back for it, but instead they'll flip it to Gantz. Now Moore.
Oh, great stick work right
Moore
there.
Moore making one defender miss. Couldn't get through the second, though. And now Millersville coming the other way. Very nicely done by the Marauders. As this time, it was Courtney Weaver.
That's a great pass. Just opens it up a bit. She's going to try to get that ball into the circle. Shippensburg wants nothing of that. That was a great stop by them.
Well, as we enter the final now 4.5 minutes of the first half, this is very crucial for both defenses. They've played so well, Pam, for 30-plus minutes now. You really don't want to give up a late goal and have all the momentum going into your opponent into the locker room.
No, this is when the team really has to just stay steady. A foot there, unfortunately, by Barnard.
So Millersville a chance to push it here, approaching 4 minutes to go in the half. Semifinal number one here of the 2016 Division II Field Hockey Championships. A new national champion this year with East Stroudsburg getting beat in the first round by the team in white, Shippensburg. East Stroudsburg last year winning in a thriller over Merrimack on a penalty stroke. Allie Roth scoring it.
Good pressure here by the Marauders. Good, they won the ball.
And great.
She's going to.
Fantastic steal on the far side and a 3-on-4 momentarily, but again, the midfield of Shippensburg doing a nice job of winning it back, at least momentarily, as Weaver picks it back up for Millersville. Well, the Marauders, a late charge here in the half.
All right, they're going to work hard to get a corner. You know, at this point, they're just thinking, let us have more scoring opportunities. So I won't be surprised if we do a pass or two and then someone's going to put a hard ball right into the circle.
They're going to try to finish the half like they started it, and that's keep the ball on this end and get a couple of chances. But Shippensburg wins it on the near sideline.
Great defense.
Kylie Huffman will flip it to the far side, past Spisak. But it's going to go right back to Millersville.
Yeah, a little bouncy. That was, had that worked, that could have opened up a complete open lane up the far sideline, but that ball took a funny bounce.
Yeah, Cassie Rawa really had about maybe 15 yards before she even got to another defender, and then
right.
She had Spisak to her left, which a defender might have had to vacate.
Right.
And that could have really started an interesting counter move, but.
That's a nice hit. Suzanne Moeller.
So on the far side, Shippensburg with it. Time winding down here in the first half. Both teams trying to chase a late goal. And we talked about it on the onset of this match. It felt like a 1-0 game. They went 1-0 back on October the 12th in the regular season when Shippensburg beat Millersville. But then it was a 2-1 affair in the PSAC championship games. We have a whistle going right back to the Marauders. Taken a bit quickly, but they'll be able to settle it from about 30 yards out. Weaver.
And you've got all but one Shippensburg player back on defense. They know what's at stake right here late in this half. They want to all pack in the defense. Let's do everything they can to keep the ball out of the circle and particularly keep it from getting to be a penalty corner.
Weaver doing a fantastic job as she floats it now to the far side. Into the circle, nearing the end line, but Shippensburg almost building a wall to prevent any type of penalty corner.
That was a smart play right there. Just get it out of that circle, clear it out.
A minute to go in the half. But now Millersville back with it as these two teams try to chase one final scoring chance in the first half. 48 seconds to go. On the far side again, the Marauders. Still with some time left. Trying to get it into the circle. Kicked right back out. Now swung back in by Weaver. A shot blocked. Weaver's played very well in the last, really, 2.5 minutes. She has been in the thick of things offensively for Millersville. And now the final chance of this first half is going to belong to Millersville.
And even if the clock goes off, the corner will be played out.
That's why you don't see a real sense of urgency from the Marauders. They know this is going to be the last chance of the half.
Right, so they're going to put their whole team up there, which they are.
A played short on the far side, swung back in, took a deflection out. They try to keep it alive. It's deflected back into the goal on the near side, but it's waved off.
All right, 0-0.
Waved off at the break after the initial penalty corner was taken short to the far side. But still, Millersville, like they started the half, looking very dangerous, but an even opening 35. So we're going to step aside, take a break. Halftime here in our first semifinal. Millersville and Shippensburg battling scoreless so far. We'll be back with more from Easton, Massachusetts in just a moment here on NCAA.com. Semifinal, the 2016 Division II Field Hockey Championships, Shippensburg and Millersville out of the PSAC, scoreless after 35 minutes alongside Pam Arpe. I'm Andrew Kappas, and Pam, exactly what we thought, at least through the first 35 minutes, a very defensive matchup so far. Both keepers have only their two of the best in the country statistically and overall. They haven't had to do much. Each had to make two saves in that first half, but the story was their defense around them kind of withstanding a couple of attacking barrages.
It was exciting to see such good defense on both teams, because when the Marauders had the ball, they worked very hard to get that ball into the circle, and Shippensburg stopped them almost every time. And same thing on the other end. When Shippensburg was trying to mount an attack, the Marauders were right there, steady sticks, taking that ball out of the circle or taking it right off their sticks. So I think, you know, we're seeing two of the best defense in Division II right now.
And despite no scoring, it was really a game of runs, because Millersville opened the half really – created things early on. Then in that middle portion of the first half, it was Shippensburg, right. And then Millersville closed it out very strong. They actually scored a goal. Now, right. The half had already ended after their penalty corner originally didn't result in a goal, but still really a game of runs so far.
Absolutely, and I wouldn't be surprised, but, you know, we might see Shippensburg come out a little bit stronger in the second half. I have to think Coach Landis is talking to them about let's keep a sustained offensive attack. But I have to think both coaches are pretty happy with their defense right now. But, you know, if this is going to come down to a one-goal game, the attacks need to get going.
Now, this is the rubber match of the season series as Shippensburg won the regular season matchup on October the 12th, 1-0. Millersville on a penalty stroke won in the PSAC tournament championship match. So matchup number 3 is going to decide who punches a ticket into the national championship game. Halftime here at WB Mason Stadium. We'll be back with more in just a moment on NCAA.com. Play Shippensburg and Millersville scoreless in the national semifinal. Semifinal number 1 here in the 2016 Division II Field Hockey Championships. Looking at our first half highlights, Pam, not many to speak of, which again is what we kind of thought was going to happen because these two defenses are so supercharged. But there were a couple of scoring chances for these two teams. But you really got to credit not just the keepers. And again, they kind of get all of the credit sometimes, whether that's right or wrong. It's almost like a quarterback when you talk about football. That sometimes they get some of the credit that isn't maybe due to them. But the keepers, they've played well when they've been tasked. But the biggest thing is, for me at least, is the back four of each team has really done a nice job of keeping their jerseys clean. As you see, really, the only real chance that Shippensburg had in the first half, now they had a couple of penalty corners, but not much going on this end for them either.
Right, could have been a potential goal right there. Here we go. Number 17 has done such a good job bringing that ball into the circle. She's been a tireless worker.
And at the end of the half, they had a goal go in, but again, it was after the penalty corner. The original chance had been created. The clock had already run out, so the chance had to be right off that penalty corner. And since it took a rebound, our center official, probably rightfully so, Pam, argued that the half was over and that we went to the locker room. And that's why the goal was disallowed. And no real argument either from Millersville.
No argument, but it could be, you know, that could give some momentum also to the Marauders, knowing that they did put one in the goal. It didn't count. But they may come back thinking, all right, we got one by that tremendous goalie.
Almost a visual reassurance, and especially with how they closed the half. They closed the half like they opened it.
They did.
Was dominating possession there. And Millersville, the Marauders, who are trying to advance to the national championship game. They won it back in 2014, trying to make it 2 out of 3 years. Semifinal number 1 here at W.B. Mason Stadium in Easton, Massachusetts, the campus of Stonehill College. Just a beautiful day in suburban Boston. And we'll be back with more with second half coverage when we come back on NCAA.com. Back to W.B. Mason Stadium here on the campus of Stonehill College in Easton, Massachusetts, alongside Pam Arpe. I'm Andrew Kappas. Semifinal number 1. And scoreless after 35 minutes of play. We're just about set for second half action as Millersville outshooting Shippensburg 4-1 in that first half, but each team getting one shot on goal, resulting in one save for Allie Mooney and Samantha Rumler, these two fantastic keepers. So half number 2 here, Pam. Millersville will start us off now. They opened up the first half with a lot of possession. They closed it significantly as well. We talked about it before we went to our final break of halftime. Maybe putting that goal into the back of the net, even though it was disallowed with the half ending, maybe that visual reassurance can maybe lead to a good start for the Marauders here in half number 2.
I'm sure that's what they're hoping, but I have to think that Shippensburg will do everything they can to put a stop to that.
We're back underway. Millersville in the black and yellow, going from right to left on your screen. Shippensburg in white, able to pick the ball off to start this half. The rubber match between these two teams, Shippensburg winning the regular season meeting on the road back on October the 12th, 1-0, but then Millersville getting revenge in the PSAC championship match, winning on a penalty stroke 2-1, so a couple of one-goal games, so it's no surprise that we're in the second half with not much separating these two teams, not just the scoreboard, but the overall team stats. Although if you are Millersville, the one thing I think you're highlighting, Pam, is the fact they were able to get 4 shots off to only the 1 for Shippensburg. despite that lengthy spell of possession in the middle part of the half.
Right, that could have been a great pass there, but I tell you, the Marauders defense just, they step in beautifully to pick off those passes.
And look who it is again. She had a very strong finish to the first half. Courtney Weaver, who helped set up that penalty corner right before the end of the break, or the end of the half. Another interception. She's number 11. She's really in the thick of things. She's the counterpart to Spizak, who we spoke highly of in half number one for Shippensburg.
Both of those
players in the middle have done a great job.
They have, and they're all over the every. If there's a play happening, they're probably a part of it. Here she is just playing tough defense, one-on-one defense.
But again, great stick work to get the ball through. A chance for Shippensburg.
And a corner.
Great job, and yet again, for Shippensburg, it's Emily Bernard. It's almost like she's got glue on the side of that stick, able to dribble through some intense pressure.
Great stick work. She's very impressive to watch.
So it'll be come in from the near side. Setting up to take it. Rawa plays it to the center. Let's see what Shippensburg can do off of this penalty corner. Swung in, a shot deflected out. As stepping out to defend that for Millersville was Taylor Parker, a 5'6 senior from Stroudsburg.
And that particular corner play, a lot of schools use it. It's a very tough one to defend because the ball comes out to the top, they pass it across the top, then back again, and you've got that flyer who goes one direction and then the other. So it's not a bad play.
Played to the top of the circle. Now takes another deflection, set up nicely, sliding out is Rumler. And the ball gets caught underneath of her. Rumler did a great job to time that run pass.
She did, and wow, she was quick. I mean, she came flying out of that goal. That was very impressive.
Take another look at it. You see her, she saw that window of opportunity to come out and smother that ball, and it's a good thing she did because that was a point-blank shot coming in for Bernard had she not made that run.
Yeah, that was impressive.
On the near side, Shippensburg will trying to get the ball restarted, but we thought maybe it was going to be Millersville who came out thanks to their strong finish in the first half, but Shippensburg, a tremendous start to this second half.
And they're putting the ball over there on their left side because they like that attack to come from the left side, so that's very interesting. Trying to get it out to number 17, Emily Barnard, who we've seen has a tremendous stick. She's quick, she can move the ball quickly.
That's going to be a matchup we're going to have to watch, too, as Weaver against Bernard.
Yes.
I think they've moved Weaver closer to her to try to prevent that transition once Shippensburg does regain possession.
Great coaching move right there because she seems the one to be the one who's controlling that offensive push.
Oh, Millersville looking for their first push of the half, but it's going to have to come maybe on the next trip down because Shippensburg winning it back. And again, Bernard, this time being marked by two players,
right.
Weaver being one of them.
That's out of respect for just how good she is.
Shippensburg picks it right back up. They got some green space on the near side if they can get it over there. It finally does end up to the stick of Rawa. Rawa in some traffic, able to get it through two defenders, now being edged off the ball as it's going to roll just to the left of the corner and over the end line. Not a bad idea there by Rawa. She had some space in front of her. She just wasn't able to get around Vanessa Schneider, who did a nice job of edging her off without fouling her. And now Schneider will be able to clear it, at least potentially clear it, but the ball picked off.
Nice pass right there.
Floated right through. On the restart, but again, good defending by Millersville, just breaking up the passing lanes.
Great defending right there.
It's out on the far side. Now, one thing that we did not see in the first half, Pam, and you're pretty familiar with this. You helped open up this building a few years ago when you were the head coach of Stonehill's field hockey team. The shadows, right now the vast majority of the field in the shadows, but right now Allie Mooney standing in the sun on the other end of the field. We haven't really had a chance to see how it might affect her or the attacking players.
Right.
But everywhere else in the shadows. And I assume, based on where the sun is setting behind us, that's not going to last very long.
Right.
Before too long, that'll be in the shadow as well.
She'll be in the shadow as well. It'll be a little easier on the full field. Now we see the Marauders, though, getting a good push.
Breaking it up on the far side, Mary Spizak. Spizak taking on two defenders on the far side, right at midfield. as we talked about earlier, just a gorgeous, gorgeous day.
Perfect playing weather. It is for the, you know, you get high 50s and 60 degrees in mid-November, and, you know, we're taking advantage of it on a beautiful day.
Absolutely. And we may not be as lucky for our championship game on Sunday, but...
But as they say in New England, just wait a few hours and it may change. So we're hoping that rain stays away.
Well, you're worried about the rain. I'm worried about the wind.
Well, that could be a...
On the far side, Millersville with the ball, trying to get their first significant possession of the half. Shippensburg, a very good opportunity a couple of minutes ago, but Samantha Rumler doing a nice job at smothering it.
Either that or...
Allie Mooney hasn't been called into question yet in the second half. She was very busy in the start of the first half. Had to make a save. On the far side, Millersville trying to swing it back towards the circle.
Just little by little, it's almost like 5-10 yards at a time. They're taking it down.
7 minutes into our second half.
Good defense again. Ball went into the circle, but Ship was right there. Knock it out.
This is our first semifinal. Our second semifinal features a bit of a different pedigree. You got two teams that have won national championships each of the last three seasons. Millersville won in 14, Shippensburg won back in 2013. Bit of an interesting story in our second semifinal, given that LIU Post has been to the championship match two of the last 3 years, but then you have an upstart St. Anselm squad who didn't even have a winning season before last year, and here they are amongst the last four.
It's exciting. I think I said earlier, you know, as a former coach, you just love to see teams pull it together, whether it's a new coach or new recruits, and, you know, all of a sudden here they are winning the regular season for the Northeast 10, playing in their first ever NCAA semifinals. So it's very exciting for the St. Anselm young ladies.
Now, it's a good crowd for this one, and that's pretty impressive considering the average trip for these two teams was about, speaking to the folks, about 9 or 10 hours to get here to Easton, Massachusetts. We should have a very raucous crowd in our second semifinal. We're hearing St. Anselm, they have a student bus that is packed full of students that's coming and should be arriving about 4:30.
I love it. And that, you know, that could make a difference for a team new to this venue, to have that fan support. Because this is a whole new ball game for the St. Anselm team.
St. Anselm is only about 30, or an hour and a half, excuse
right.
me, away from W.B. Mason Stadium. Typically alternates between who hosts the semifinals and national championship game. Last year, the PSAC's Bloomsburg
right.
did a fantastic job hosting, and Stonehill doing a great job this year with the NE10.
And last year, the day was very similar to this. It was
beautiful,
close to 60 degrees, perfect field hockey weather.
And a whistle, and this is going to be a good opportunity for Millersville. They haven't really had a chance to bother Allie Mooney, but let's see how the sun versus the shadows affects her. But a nice interception right on the edge of the circle, and a strong clearance.
What a great outlet pass.
If you can get it out to Bernard, they weren't able to do it then, but...
She could have had a... good run towards the goal.
There's only two defenders back in front of Samantha Rumler. But it did not end up bothering Millersville. And now Shippensburg can clear, though, off the restart. Wind, not much of a factor either. Blowing across the field from left to right, but again, not very strong, so it really hasn't affected much. At midfield, Weaver had a chance to pick it off. Near sideline, Rawa. Rawa threw two defenders, now threw a third. Tried to take on a fourth and ended up being one too many.
Great defensive move right there.
Great job by Millersville as they got the counter out and a whistle, so they'll turn up field now. Oh, we're 10.5 minutes into the second half. Still scoreless between Millersville and Shippensburg in our first semifinal. One of these two teams will move on and try to win their second national title in just the last couple of years. But again, we'll have a new one for the fourth straight year, beginning in 2012 when Westchester won the second of their back-to-back titles. The history has been very PSAC heavy, but LIU Post and St. Anselm will try to change that. Westchester beat UMass Lowell 5-0 back in 2012, and that started this current run of new champions. Westchester, they won their second straight in 2012, but then Shippensburg in 13, Millersville in 14, and then East Stroudsburg winning a national championship last year, edging Merrimack in overtime on a penalty stroke by Ali Roth. But you love that parity with new champions, because we did go through quite a run, especially the 90s, Pam, where it was one team heavy, Bloomsburg, who hosted the national championship last year. They were a very good bet every year to win, as they had quite a few runs. They've won 11 national championships.
It's a tremendous program, you know, and continues to be so strong, but they did have quite a run in the 90s with their national championships.
Now, the last any 10 team to win a title was UMass Lowell back in 2010. But it has been PSAC dominant even before UMass Lowell. But LIU Post, they have the pedigree again. You don't want to look too far ahead. You got St. Anselm, a team that is upstart, only their second winning season back-to-back now.
Right.
And then you have LIU Post, who they've been to the championship match two of the last three seasons.
They have, and I think having played in the two of the last three seasons, they're hungry. I have to think they're going to come in here with something to prove. But we'll see what St. Anne's give them. Because St. Anselm at this point, yes, it is their first time, but, you know, I have to think they're going to play on a mission. They're on a mission to prove themselves that they are for real.
And Shippensburg right now on a mission to try to clear, as Millersville is, again, similar to what they did in the first half, Pam. They haven't had many chances in the circle, but they have been able to keep the ball on that end. But as I say that, Shippensburg able to flip it across midfield here.
Fairly soon, we're going to see perhaps more of a sense of urgency from both teams.
Yeah, that you start to see that clock. Once you go below 20, you start to feel that sense of urgency, like you were saying, that, you know, what the next goal could win.
Right.
Because it is from the get-go, we've been saying this has all the makings of a 1-0 game.
Right, and we're seeing that right now. And you're right, under 20, you start to think, okay, someone's going to score, and it needs to be our team.
Because just the way these two teams are playing, the way the two defenses are playing, it's really going to be an uphill task to try to make up two goals in 20-plus minutes, and then
absolutely,
if you would need overtime.
It has all the makings of a one-goal game. And as that clock ticks down, they're going to feel it. And I'm sure the coaches, you know, anytime they send somebody in from the sideline, there's probably that message. You need to help make things happen out here.
That certainly opens it up a little bit, too, because you start to see some chances being taken that maybe you didn't see in the opening 45, 50 minutes, which creates some more space for your attackers, and also creates the biggest thing, I think, Pam, more counterattacking opportunities, and that really can open the match
up. That can totally open the match. One good, you know, defensive move and sending that ball out of the circle strong, and there may be a breakaway. These teams are quick. They're in great shape. It wouldn't surprise me, but we could see somebody get a ball and go the full length.
And that's exactly what happened last season. You may remember with what set up that winning goal for East Stroudsburg. It was a match that we didn't really expect to be a very competitive one. Thought maybe East Stroudsburg was going to handle Merrimack fairly easily, but Merrimack battled.
Gave them everything. Went to
overtime, and then it was off a restart, a one-on-one opportunity, the foul occurring, really a professional foul, just to give a chance for Merrimack to cover it. And then Ali Roth converting the penalty stroke last season to give the Warriors their national title.
Very dramatic win, for sure.
Will we see something similar here in our first semifinal? A matchup of...
Well, as a coach, you really like to get it done in regulation time, I have to say, because anything can happen in overtime. So I have to think these coaches...
Yeah, that's the extra wrinkle, is it's a sudden death, golden goal, however you want to phrase it. Which can be a very stressful time for coaches. Not that there's maybe a less stressful time, especially this time of year.
Right.
On the near side, Millersville trying to work it towards Allie Mooney. Again, she's been very unbothered in this half. Samantha Rumler, in her defense, she hasn't had to do much, but she had to make one brilliant play.
Great save, yep.
But Allie Mooney, somebody might run out a lawn chair to her or something, maybe can sip on some iced tea, and her defense has...
fairly casual out there, but you know mentally she's ready for the play.
Well, I liked what she did in the first half when Shippensburg went through that run. You made a comment on it. She came out about maybe 20 yards out just to try to be close to the action.
Yep.
And can't quite do that here with the ball on this end, but now Shippensburg and the Raiders will try to clear.
Millersville is giving it everything they can to get that ball deep into their own scoring territory, but Shippensburg's doing everything they can to keep it out, and they're doing a very nice job out of it. That's good team defense right there.
Near side, Rawa with it. Rawa trying to send it upfield, and that got a lot.
What's the overtime situation?
The ball right into her, so that is a turnover.
Jessica Beard got the worst of that. Beard, a sophomore from Dauphin, Pennsylvania.
But you'll notice that she bounces right back. I love that about field hockey players. That ball is very hard, and you get hit all the time. And, yes, it does sting, but these girls are used to it, and they bounce right back.
Weaver.
Nice stop there by Shippensburg.
Weaver, again, like she did in the first half, able to dribble in traffic and gets a really good chance now here for Millersville.
Although, punch for punch
turnover
for
inside the circle, so back to the Raiders.
Job looking up, scanning that field to see what she's got.
And that ball will roll all the way back to Rumler.
But this can also, Shippensburg is going to put a lot of pressure to keep it down here because they can only bring that ball out to the 16-yard line.
Chip forward.
That's a great pass. That's a great pass.
And they got numbers here.
They
three
do.
On four if they can
hurry.
They
read that well because the whole Shippensburg team was down.
Inside the circle. The
nice
shot
stop.
Is blocked. On the far side, still alive, as Ariana Gray's had a shot come in. And now the Marauders will try again right on the end line. The backside official coming in. It's going to be Marauders ball on the far side, again near the end line. Looks like right now the Marauders just trying to get a penalty corner.
They're trying.
Now that numbers are back.
Right, they're hard. They're really trying to get a corner right here.
16:45 left in regulation. Ball loose in the circle for a moment. Chip back in the front, but a key interception.
Pickoff right there. That was excellent timing.
And again, like we talk about, when you're a defender inside the circle, you just got to whisk it out of there and then worry about what comes next when it happens.
Right,
and that's exactly what, you know, maybe not the most clean clearance, but again, it was away from the center of goal and out of danger, the biggest thing.
Right, and these young ladies are practicing that every day in practice. Hard balls hit at them, they stop, they take it out of the circle and release it.
But Millersville with some momentum here that Shippensburg trying to stall and see if they can here on a counter move. Ooh, nearly a great feed by Bernard as she tried to pick out her teammate to her right, Susanna Mueller, who was running with her. Now Shippensburg just trying to weather the storm here for Millersville.
Mm-hmm.
They have the ball near midfield.
Is camera one playing?
Weaver again.
Again.
And she has been tremendous in that midfield for Millersville.
She plays that position for a reason. She sees the field so well. She sees once she gets that ball, she knows exactly where she needs to put it.
Now, Weaver versus Spezak would have been a really good matchup, and it was for the first 15 minutes,
right.
But then they moved Weaver a little bit closer to Bernard because of her success playing with the ball.
Right.
But still a great matchup to see there in the midfield. And it's a great interception. Ball taken right away by Lexi Robeson. Robeson all by herself creating this offensive chance. Just a freshman from Hershey, Pennsylvania.
And Weaver on the ball. She can take her time trying to find that right person to send it to. What a great pass right there.
On the near side, trying to just work through some traffic here. Shippensburg doing a nice job getting bodies back. Clearance disrupted, but Shippensburg will send it downfield, at least have a chance to. Under 15 to go in regulation. Crunch time for both of these teams. And I think what you spoke about earlier, Pam, about the match maybe opening up because of time running out, I think you're starting to see that, some more green space.
Mm-hmm.
As both of these teams trying to get a late goal. Weaver picks it up. In traffic, couldn't quite find a teammate, but it bounces back to Robeson. Robeson on the near side, wins it. Just on the other side of midfield.
Again, Mueller has done such a great job. One-on-one, she comes up with that ball most of the time, and she delivers a great pass to a teammate. Foot right there, so it gives Shippensburg the ball.
Shippensburg couldn't get it. Man, Weaver just everywhere.
She saw that.
Able to find a counter move coming up here for Millersville, but again, Shippensburg back in numbers, but Millersville will try to find some attacking space, but the ball taken away. Robeson trying to keep the attack alive. She at least slows down the counter as Rawa picks it up. Rawa, a giveaway there.
Weaver, that's a nice ball. But Mueller, once again, she sees where that ball's going, and she's able to pick that off. A little bump right there will give Shippensburg the ball.
That professional foul from Vanessa Schneider.
Right.
Now Shippensburg with it. See if they can float it to Spisak. Right now she's atop the NCAA logo, but instead it's a turnover. Millersville taking it quickly on the far side, moving forward. Mizak, the leading goal scorer this season with 8 for Millersville. Mizak just a sophomore. Both of these teams have quite a few young contributors.
They
we talked
do.
A lot about Allie Mooney, who's just a sophomore, but Mizak's just a sophomore as well. And again, Bernard. It's like she's got glue on the stick.
She does, but look at that defense get back. The Marauders defense, as soon as she got the ball, the four defenders just hustled back. It's a nice ball going.
Great ball in. Bernard able to tip it toward the far post, and it's kicked away by Rumler.
What a great clear. What a great clear right there. Get that ball away from the circle as far as you can.
Somehow that ball got through, and Bernard was ready to send that one out towards the far post, and Rumler calmly just
calmly
swooped it away with the right foot. But again, and it hasn't come often, but when Shippensburg has been on this end, it seems like they've been able to make something happen.
Mm-hmm.
Rumler has been called into question twice, and she's answered the bell both times this half. Schneider initially had it, but it's going to be won by Selassie. Freshman.
Mueller has great hard hits, and there's another one.
Right through to the edge of the circle, now in it. A whistle inside, and it's going to go. It's going to be against Millersville. So, again, they haven't had many chances inside the circle this half, but Shippensburg has been able to make them interesting, and let's see if they can make this penalty corner count.
Talking about which one they're going to do.
Such a big corner
this
as well.
It's huge with 10 minutes left. These corners, we don't see too many of them in this game, so every one is a potential score.
On the near side, played back.
Interesting.
Right along the end line, back out to the front, trying to center it up. Ball still loose. Rumler had a chance to kick it away, elected not to, and we're going to have another one. But a nice job at Shippensburg, not panicking.
Not at all.
Not taking the first available shot, but kind of waiting patiently.
Right.
And you saw in close quarters, Bernard trying to restart the attack, and then play whistle dead for a corner. So the penalty corner coming up. And again, it's going to be taken by Shippensburg's Hannah Selassie. On the far post, centered up, but
yeah.
Mr. teammate Selassie will settle it back.
Right.
Clearance finally gotten out of the circle. Selassie chipping it back in. Not out of danger yet. And a swing and a miss, and that's going to be a whistle.
A little high hit right there, a little danger.
So that'll give Millersville an opportunity to clear. And you can kind of see the angst. I think the play was blown dead because the restart was taken a bit too quickly. So both of these teams kind of really getting that sense of urgency
yes.
now.
Yes. And they know that they've got to take advantage of every opportunity they have right now.
Under 9.5 to play in regulation, our first semifinal.
Good defense right there. Great team defense.
And the Marauders a chance to clear as they'll bump up where they take this from. About 15 yards from goal, maybe 5 from the circle.
That was a great throw. That was very accurate.
And they move it all the way up to midfield. A great turn there made by Kyra Brakefield, another freshman contributor. Brakefield chasing after it on the near sideline. And the ball won back by Millersville. Carly Castle. Castle was taking the,
as
Weaver intercepted again. And some looked like obstruction there, Pam, as stepping in front was Morgan Gantz, and I think that was a bit of a professional foul just to kind of slow things down. As Mooney wouldn't have counted. Whistle had been blown, but she does kick it away. Always like that if you're a keeper, you get a chance to defend something that doesn't count.
That's
so if things do go wrong, if things do go wrong, you're not penalized for picking the ball out of your own net because it won't count.
Right.
But she did handle it well, even though it was played dead or a whistle dead.
She did.
And they turn to the other side of the field, and again, we're seeing that open play as Bernard has it taken away from her. Weaver with it now at midfield, but won back by Shippensburg. Match really opening up. A beautiful pass. Spizak now on the far side. Spizak working her way into the circle. Spizak going to ground, flipping it in front. Still alive as Selassie makes contact, and we have a whistle inside the circle, and we have an injured Millersville Marauder. Spaticchia is down and in need of medical attention. It was a big collision. But first, the buildup as Spaticchia, and she got a knee, just an inadvertent right knee from Selassie. And this is very concerning for Millersville. Anytime you see a head injury, you cringe, Pam.
You just don't want to see that.
And that's exactly what happened, and Selassie, not intentional by any means. She was just coming back out, and it just so happened Spaticchia was going down to ground, and the two kind of just converged. And you just hope she can continue. But she is still on the ground. Clock stopped at 7:31 left in the second half. We're scoreless between Shippensburg and Millersville, so the two teams will huddle up while Spaticchia receives medical attention inside the circle.
Her head is up now, so that's a good sign. But no one likes to see a player go down, and that was just, it was inadvertent contact.
Especially with a head injury, they're so scary, especially now that, you know, you have all this recently discovered science behind, you know, high-speed collisions that involve the head. And she is sitting up now. I think she might be bleeding, and I think that's one reason why she wasn't moving, is they're just trying to get that stopped out there.
Okay.
Which may be better than what the original, what it looked like before. Is we see a good crowd on hand today, and we expect it to swell in numbers for our second semifinal. The bus is not here yet for St. Anselm.
We haven't heard it.
But
anyway.
We expect it to be here in about an hour and 10 minutes.
Right.
Their ETA was 4:30.
Okay.
Hopefully they brought enough pizza for us, Pam. But they got pizza on that bus too.
That's always welcome. That's right. They had quite a deal for those students, I think. Good job, St. Anselm, to support your field hockey team.
And very good to see as Spaticchia will, with a little bit of help, come off the field, but mostly under her own power.
Good.
And again, with 7:31 left in the half, we might not see her in regulation, but hopefully she can continue, whether it be later in this match or on Sunday if Millersville were to advance.
And no doubt the Marauders are going to pull together even more right now, knowing that one of their key players is off. We are not going to see any sense of panic here.
No.
And these are talented young ladies, and they can play through an awful lot.
Spaticchia was doing a nice job teaming up with Weaver there in the middle, so now Weaver's going to be called upon really even more to play that big presence in the midfield.
Well, she can do it. She's been so solid this whole game.
Now Shippensburg back with the ball. Time running out for a late goal. And then you get into the very unpredictable golden goal overtime format if one of these two teams can't find a goal before the end of regulation, as there's Weaver again. But a whistle blown dead. Shippensburg back with it in some traffic. Gotten to Selassie, but she can't get around Schneider. Schneider's done a nice job of using her body to kind of just get in the way of the attack for Shippensburg.
And that's Taylor Parker right there, who, interestingly, is partially deaf, number 10 for Millersville. She plays a key position on defense, and to play that without using any of her aids is amazing.
Selassie in some traffic, able to dribble through three different defenders, and she wins a penalty corner for Shippensburg.
Here we go.
Well, you're right, speaking about Taylor Parker. You know, how difficult is that just to not be able to hear your keeper
right
behind you?
But somehow they've worked out their communication because she's right on the same page with everybody else.
They're going to need it here as Bernard will send in the penalty corner from the far side. 6 minutes to go. Played to the center.
Interesting. We haven't seen that corner set up before.
Weaver getting in the way, but now the ball gotten through towards the far post,
and
it's into the back of the net.
That's in.
Shippensburg, a late goal with 5:50, and the Raiders take a 1-0 lead here in the first semifinal. Bernard.
And Emily Bernard, and I guess we're not surprised by that, are we? What a goal.
On the other end, you see her waiting on that far post, and she just got a good deflection, got enough of the stick on it there, Pam. Didn't hit it cleanly, but got enough of the stick on it to push it across the line. Actually, it hit her right thigh. Might have hit her right thigh and went in, but it must have hit the stick.
It must have hit the stick
in the final portion of it.
They were practicing during their warm-up. They were working on those deflections, so good for Shippensburg to use that right there. She was in the right place at the right time with that steady stick.
So Shippensburg, just like that, 5.5 minutes away from going to the national championship game. And Millersville left to chase a late goal here with 5 minutes to go. And we talked about it, Pam, how this felt like a 1-0 game. And just to find a goal has been so difficult.
It has, but now I have a sense we're going to see some urgency on the part of the Marauders. 5 minutes left. They've got to mount their attack right now.
Shippensburg, who, again, did not get that first round bye after getting beat by Millersville in the PSAC championship game. They won 18 games in the regular season. They went 9-1 in conference. Beat Millersville in the regular season. And our 2013 national champion looking to punch their ticket back into the national title game. Just minutes away from doing so. 4.5 to be exact.
They just have to play steady. They've got to just withstand any attack that the Marauders give them right now.
What a job by Emily Bernard all game long.
All game.
And then she got a much-deserved goal. For Bernard, that's her 8th goal of the year, second on the team.
She's been very impressive from the start of the game, so it's nice to see her rewarded with that goal. Great hit by Shippensburg right there.
It'll trickle all the way through to Rumler, who will kick it back out.
Good clear. What a great clear. Right to a player, which is not easy to do. But that was a fabulous clear by
Spizak wins it back, though, for Shippensburg. And these are going to be precious seconds that tick away with Shippensburg with the ball.
They're certainly not backing down.
Looking to turn upfield, Millersville. They'll have the ball and just trying to get it down in that end and see if they can spend the last 3.5 minutes there and see if they can get an equalizer.
Maybe get a corner. But they've got to be going all out right now just to get that ball on their stick. Nice job right there, just looking for someone to pass it to.
Dribbling in traffic, taken away momentarily, but one right back. Spizak.
Push.
And wins the foul.
Right.
And the yellow comes out. Yellow against Millersville and Carly Castle.
All right, and that is 5 minutes, so we will not see her return to this game in regulation.
Even more adversity for the Marauders, already playing down 1-0. Here's Bernard as they look for the knockout goal. Already up 1-0 with time ticking down.
Yellow card was issued, number 15. for Millersville.
Now Shippensburg with the ball and the lead as time winds down in our first semifinal here tonight. Near sideline.
Good hard hit.
Spizak tried to make the turn, but Weaver wins it back for Millersville. Weaver restarting it quickly. Every second so precious for the Marauders as we approach 2 minutes to go in the match. Shippensburg just looking to clear. They have a 1-0 lead on a goal by Emily Bernard off a penalty corner.
You can see the Marauders, they're going to challenge every pass now. They've got to get that ball on their stick. The chip isn't going to make it easy for them.
Cleared all the way back to Rumler.
Use that clock.
.118 to play in regulation. Millersville running out of time to chase an equalizer as Spizak wins it back for Shippensburg. The Raiders just looking to run out the clock.
Right. Use their time right here. This is not a bad idea whatsoever.
Right at 1 minute to go.
1 minute left in the second half.
1-0 Shippensburg as they look to advance to the national championship game for the first time since winning it back in 2013. And ironically, they beat Millersville in the semifinal round that year as well. And who they beat in the championship game? LIU Post,
right,
who will be playing later on tonight to try to go back to that national championship game. They'll take on upstart St. Anselm at 5 o'clock. But still 30 seconds to cover for Shippensburg as they have the ball back.
Right.
And a look for the knockout punch is Bernard in the circle.
And the corner.
And that'll pretty much do it for Shippensburg, as they'll be able to run out the clock, take the penalty corner, and it'll all be elementary, basically, as they have all but shored themselves a spot in Sunday's national championship game. Bernard, the goal scorer, will take the penalty corner from the far side, but it is clinched now with zeros on the scoreboard, as Shippensburg, one final chance at goal. Once they hear the final whistle, they know that ticket will be punched. And there it is.
That's it.
The Raiders getting a late goal from Emily Bernard with less than 7 minutes to play. And they are going back to the national championship game for the first time since they won it back in 2013.
What a game. 1-0. Defense, goal lead. Just that one goal made all the difference.
Now they traveled some 9 hours to get here, so you know the Raiders were going to run over and celebrate with their visiting fans. Bernard, her 8th goal of the year in the closing moments of the match off a penalty corner. Now Millersville had a decent chance a number of occasions, especially in the first half. They could not push across that goal, especially in that opening 15 when they had 4 penalty corners. And Shippensburg kind of settled the flow of the game down and got the late goal from Bernard. Now Millersville, one final huddle. A very great season for the Marauders, as their season, though, will wrap up in the national semifinal with Shippensburg punching their ticket into Sunday's national championship game. Again, that'll be on NCAA.com. It'll get underway at 1 o'clock. So Shippensburg, big congratulations as they are moving on, looking for their first national title since 2013. You see the winner from Bernard, as Shippensburg will await the winner of LIU Post and St. Anselm, our second semifinal game, so we very well could see a rematch of that 2013 national title game. So that does it for us here in semifinal number 1. Shippensburg moves on. They are heading to the national championship game on Sunday. Final score, Shippensburg 1, Millersville nothing. For Pam Arpe, Haley, and everybody here at WB Mason Stadium, I'm Andrew Kappas saying thanks for watching, and we'll see you in semifinal number 2 on NCAA.com.
working in this thing right now. I know. The future's right in the night. As long as that game, I know. Double over.